Okay, all of them are on, bro.
I just need a place to sit. Well, good morning and happy Sabbath, church family. All right, that was almost good. So we are just thrilled that you are here, whether you're a member or a visitor, to one of our favorite Sabbaths of the year. It's Education Sabbath in our Highland Elementary School. All of our littles and bigs and everybody in between, we are thrilled that you're going to be leading us in worship today. And I know that's why we have a lot of guests here. If you are a guest to our church, please raise your hand right now. Yeah, look around, church members. Amen. Well, we hope and pray that you find this Sabbath a restful Sabbath, but also a time of worship and praise as Highland Elementary School leads us in worship. I do want to, before I get into my normal welcome, I just want to say a special thank you to all the Highland Elementary School teachers and staff. Amen? Amen. They do an incredible job with our young people, and just know we are truly blessed to have you all as our representatives at Highland Elementary. And we know that your job is sometimes very tiring and taxing, but luckily it's never because of us parents. We truly are blessed to have you and the patience and wisdom that you have working with our young people. And I just pray a blessing over you and your family, not just today, but through the rest of the year. We're wrapping up the school year, and I know that's hard to believe. It just feels like yesterday that we had you all come up and introduce yourselves and did the blessing over you, and now it's at the end of the year. So we are truly blessed, and I do want to welcome you. A couple of announcements that we have. In the pew in front of you, if you are a guest or a member and you want to get more involved in our church, or you want to interested in Bible studies or baptism or whatever, pick up the Connect card in the pew and fill it out, or you can scan the QR code that my wife doesn't like in the back and fill it out digitally. She would rather us just do the hand one and turn it in. But if you want to turn it in, you can put it in the box in the back, or you can hand it to one of the elders or myself. Pastor Steve is gone right now to conference meetings. But if you want to see him, you can hand it to him too whenever you see him. The other one is our prayer cards. Our prayer cards are a great opportunity for you to share with the elders of what we can pray over or praise over of what's going on in your life. And that's in the pew in front of you as well, the white cards. And during the time of our elder prayer, there's a time where you can come forward as we sing, if you so wish, and put it in the Bible of the elder. And then we'll pass that out to the elders, and we will pray over that confidentially. If you're uncomfortable coming forward during that time, that's okay as well. You can hand it to one of the elders or pastors, or you can put it in the box in the back with the offering, and that will get to us as well that way. Just want to encourage you to do that. We have a lot of announcements in the bulletin as well as in the newsletter. We're sorry for the late notice of the newsletter. It went out this morning. We apologize. We just had a lot of things going on. But Highland Elementary School has some announcements in there with the Forest School on Sunday, as well as some other things. The Academy has, Highland Academy has some things in there that's coming up with the drama, as well as Alumni Weekend, Academy Days. This is a very busy time for our church. But one thing that's not a normal thing is April 19, which I know is during a home leave, but that Friday night, Andrews Academy, their music groups are coming and they're touring through our area, and they are putting on a Vespers concert for us. So I'd encourage you to come out, support Andrews Academy, because I know our band and choir and music musicians go and travel other places and ask for their churches to open up, and we encourage that. So we want to return the favor to Andrews, one of our sister academies from Michigan. And so that's April 19. It's in the newsletter. That's something new. As well as our church campout. Our church campout's coming along here shortly. And if you want more information about that, it's in the newsletter. But you can talk to the Kuntz, Tim Kuntz. He has more information if you need about that. There's plenty of other things that are happening. I want to encourage you, this next Thursday is our Men's Thrive Group. So spouses of husbands, please encourage your spouse to come to that Thursday night meeting at 7. It's a great time for men to get together and to break bread, to share. And just want to encourage you, Men's Thrive Group at 7 this Thursday. We are going to be wrapping it up for the summer here soon. And during the summer, we're going to not do it, but then we'll get back started again. The women met this last Thursday, and the men's group Thrive is this Thursday at 7. So just encourage you to come out for that. As I said, there's other announcements in the bulletin as well as in the newsletter. I encourage you to look on that. At this time, I would like you to stand for opening prayer, and then we'll just continue on with the service. Let's bow our heads. Our gracious God, we just praise you for right now, for the fact that we collectively can celebrate what's happening in our young people's lives. Lord, you have, as a church, put us as stewards of these young people, Lord. And we want to be faithful in that. And by by doing this and mentoring them in worship and praise and leading out in worship and praise in the church service, Lord, we are setting the foundation for the next generation to come as we tell the future generation how you have blessed us in the past so that they can become the new generation that maybe finishes the work. And so, Lord, as we worship today, as we praise and celebrate today, as we see these young people share the talents you've given them today, may your Holy Spirit rain down on us, is our prayer. In Jesus' name, amen.
And singing Amazing Grace, Our Chains Are Gone. Sanctuary. Thanks.
Please bow your heads for prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we come before you with hearts full of gratitude for your boundless grace. We thank you for the strength and courage you have given us, knowing that through you we can triumph over any challenge. Help us embrace this truth and carry it with us as we present our worship service. May your presence be felt among us and guarding our words and actions. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Please open your Bibles with me to 1 Corinthians 15:57. That's 1 Corinthians 15:57. I'll be reading from the New Living Translation. But thank God, he gives us the victory over sin and death through our Lord Jesus Christ.
Faithful to the end, so Good morning, church family. Our offering today is for our local church budget. We are grateful today for being able to be a part of your church family. Our God chose us to be co-workers with him. I believe he did this because he knows we would be more invested in his work if we are actively involved in ministry. The money collected today will go to support your local ministries, such as Sabbath School materials, our building repairs, and your local church schools. Today, God has given us the opportunity to give God what belongs to him and give from our thankful hearts.
Please bow your heads. Dear Father in heaven, thank you for the victory you have given us in Christ. We are eternally grateful for what you have given us. We thank you for our homes, for the necessities of life you provide, but we are especially thankful for the gift of Jesus. Please prepare the path of our lives so that our lives may be in harmony with God's word. Please receive our tithes and offerings as we lay them at your feet. We ask all this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Children, it is now your time to come forward for children's story. If there are any children in the audience, remember we're going to collect those dollars, $10, $20, $100 bills. Just bring them over to the little church buildings up front. Looks like we're having the same problem the Israelites had. They have to hold back the offerings because it's so much. Amen.
Welcome, boys and girls. Young children, life is tough. There are no easy roads in my short life. I've had the share of challenges. Number one, math. Number two, moving and leaving old friends. And number three, death. The death of my dog, Jane.
Kids, you will also have your share of challenges, so you're going to need some help. You're going to need Jesus. 1 Corinthians 15:57 says, "But thanks be to God, he gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ."
Boys and girls, this is your life without Jesus.
It didn't work.
And this is your life with Jesus.
Maybe you didn't see that. That was an egg that fell into this tray, and it bounced. But then we threw it again, and it broke. Yeah. The little bouncy ball that she had bounced. So there's a verse in the Bible, and it says this, Proverbs 24:16. It says, "For though a righteous man may fall seven times, he still gets up. But the wicked stumble in bad times." With Jesus, you are like the bouncy ball. you will always bounce back. And little boys and girls, if you want a bouncy ball, I have one for you. You just have to find me after church. So please listen to the sermon. It's all about victory in Christ. You may go back to your seats.
Plunge me Happy Sabbath, Highland Church family. It is now time for our church family prayer. If you have filled out those prayer cards and would like to come forward, you can do so at this time. Dear Lord, I thank you for this beautiful Sabbath day that you have given us, for the opportunity for each one of us to be here in your house of worship today. Lord, there are many here, some who have come forward, others who have not, with heavy burdens on our hearts, burdens that we long for you to lead in. We know that in your infinite wisdom and matchless love, we will find the peace and the answers to the problems that we seek. We remember that you said, in this world will we have tribulation, but we are also thankful that you have overcome the world. And so because of that, we bring our cares to you, our problems, our frustrations, and we cast them upon you, for we know that you care for us. Lord, I thank you for your many blessings. I thank you and praise you for overcoming the world, for dying that we might live, and for reconciling us to you. Lord, I thank you for these young people who are ministering to us today to draw us close to the foot of the cross. Thank you for the work that you do in each of our lives. We know that your mercies are new each morning. We praise you for those mercies, and we praise you for all that you do in our lives. As we go about our daily struggles, as we leave this place, help us to go with confidence, knowing that you are with us, that you will guide us. We thank you for hearing and answering our prayers. This we ask in your holy name. Amen.
God is L-O-V-E. love is kind, it does not envy. Love protects, it perseveres, it does not boast. Love's not rude, it is not proud or easily angered. Love always trusts, love always hopes, love will prevail.
Lord, with your voice, this kind of love's a choice. Let's show the world that love will never fail. So about love, love, I love you, Lord, above all else. It's all about L-O-V-E, love. Say bye-bye to pride and leave the past behind.
In this world, we all face challenges, feeling overwhelmed by the obstacles that seem insurmountable, that the odds are against us. We get anxious and nervous. We are tempted to doubt the plan that God has for us. We feel trapped by our fallen human nature, unable to break from the shackles of sin and discouragement. The good news is that we have the promise of victory. We are going to tell four unique stories that show how in times of fear, uncertainty, and discouragement, we can find victory in Christ. Our first story takes place in the time of Judges when the Midianites are threatening the people. Gideon is chosen as a leader, and through a series of tests, he gathers a group of 300 soldiers against a much larger army.
God, I don't mean any disrespect, but how are we supposed to defeat this massive army with only 300 men? We're really outnumbered. What? You want me to go straight into enemy territory? I mean, I'll follow you no matter what, but that just seems a little dangerous. You know, I think it'd be better if we just... All right, I'm on my way. Pura, let's go for a walk.
Don't you mean that way?
Nope. We're going this way.
That is right towards the Midianite camp.
I know. That's what God told me to do, so we gotta do it.
What, you want me to walk right into enemy territory?
Sounds familiar.
You know, you haven't really convinced me yet that torches, trumpets, and clay pots are the best options for battle gear. But why?
Are you with me?
And you were to choose the men who lap from the water like a dog?
I know. I have big questions, too. But throughout the whole thing, I can see that God knows what he's talking about. We just need to trust him.
We're getting very close to the Midianite camp. Now it's time to listen and stand very still.
Whoa, wake up.
Is that you, Zeba?
Who else would it be, Zeb? I had a nightmare. It must be some bad figs that are causing these dreams.
Will you just go back to bed? I need my beauty sleep.
Just listen for a minute. It was disturbing, like a vision of things to come.
I think you're just nervous. Clearly, we're the superior army.
How would you interpret this? A gigantic loaf of bread rolls down the hill behind us into our camp.
I don't think you're just nervous. I also think you're very hungry, thinking about bread. You are always thinking with your stomach.
Listen to me. This loaf of bread came tumbling down the hill behind us and hit a tent.
Was there any milk and honey to go with that bread?
Just listen. The force of this loaf was so strong that when it struck the tent fell over and collapsed, flat, like a pancake.
There you go again, thinking with your stomach. Now you're thinking about pancakes. Any syrup with that?
You were right. I am nervous. Something feels different, ominous.
You know, you may be onto something. I have been thinking about the God of the people of Israel. This is nothing else but the sword of Gideon.
Well, anyways, I'm going back to bed.
Me too.
We need to get everyone up. The Lord has delivered the camp of Midian into our hands.
God worked in a miraculous way, using an army equipped with torches, trumpets, and pitchers. He provides the victory, no matter what the odds are against us. God called prophets at times to bring special messages and minister to the people. In our second story, we tell the story of Elisha, who lived among the people, encouraging and helping in times of need. God revealed details of military operations of enemies to Elisha, saving the people of Israel from disaster.
Advisors, I have called you together for an important meeting. This is urgent. Which one of you is the spy?
Not I.
Not I.
Not I.
Well, if you're all really so innocent, can you please tell me why the Israelites always know when they're going to attack?
Why would we? I mean, I can't speak for the rest of these guys. Be sharing our secrets with our enemies.
What are you trying to do? Throw us under a bus? We are innocent, I promise.
Well, someone is sharing our secrets, and I intend to find out who.
Sir, with all due respect to you, King, I have some intelligence to share.
You are anything but intelligent, but let me hear what you have to say.
There is a prophet in Israel, Elijah, and his God reveals the very secrets you speak now. I dare say, even in your bedroom.
What are you going to do about this prophet, Elisha? We cannot let him continue to disrupt our military planning.
We are very capable, sir.
That is to be seen, how capable you all are. Well, what are you doing? Go get him and bring him to me.
If we hurry, maybe Elisha won't know that we're trying to get him.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Well, Elisha, I'm going to go up to the city wall to get the sunrise.
Okay.
Oh, what a beautiful... This might not be a so beautiful morning. Elisha, we are definitely not alone.
Clearly we are in a city with many other people.
No, people out there, there's lots of them. Angry, mean people.
Is that all you see?
Is that all I see? What do you mean, is that all I see? We are surrounded.
Why are you afraid?
So typically, when an army surrounds a city, one of two can happen. Immediate attack or long prolonged siege.
But we have a much stronger army than them.
Well, unless you can call the army up right now, we are sitting ducks.
Do not fear, for those who are with us are more than those who are with them.
Am I looking at the same army here? There is lots of them, and our town's defenses are not up for a fight.
God has always provided. Remember the time he provided oil for the widow and restored the life of the Shunammite's son. Also, he fed hundreds of men with only 20 loaves of bread.
You know, that's really good because I can't go hungry for long. And typically, sieges can last a really, 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 really long time.
Lord, I pray, open his eyes that he may see.
Well, wow, horses and chariots and fire, that's many more than the Syrians.
Everything is going to be okay, because the Lord has not left us here without his amazing presence.
At times where we feel that God has left us alone, he wants us to realize that we too are surrounded by spiritual forces much greater than the adversity we see with our senses. He wants us to have the spiritual eyesight to see the unseen. When Jesus came to earth, he showed the power of God through self-sacrificing love. When Jesus came to earth, he showed the power of God through self-sacrificing love. Sometimes the most powerful of God's victories are shown in changed hearts and lives. In our third story, we see God's victory in the story of a man by the name of Zacchaeus.
What a day! I thought that line of taxpayers would never end!
Zacchaeus, did you bring home the new pair of shoes I was wanting?
Not today, but I can't help but say the money I've been making recently has helped add to your growing fleet of shoes.
Are you okay this evening? Did anyone give you trouble on the way home?
No.
Did the neighborhood kids call you wee little man?
Not today, but I can't help but feel like something is missing.
Well, I'm missing my new pair of shoes.
You know, the money does have its benefits, but it comes at a cost. Ever since I've taken this job, we don't have any friends anymore. A lot of things have changed, including me.
It is lonely at times. When I go to the marketplace, I get a lot of cold stares.
Wait, you remember what I told you about Matthew, the tax collector?
Yeah, what about him?
He gave up his job and is following Jesus around the countryside. My first thoughts were that he was crazy, from having a stable job and dependable income to living, traveling around the countryside, following this teacher.
You know what I did here in the marketplace? That is, after being stared, or should I say glared at, that Jesus is coming into town this evening.
Wait, really?
No. Now, I don't want you to get any crazy ideas about wandering around the countryside and following this teacher named Jesus. I won't allow it.
I still have to see him. I'll be back for supper.
Jesus! Jesus! Jesus!
Make room for the master.
Guys, I can't see.
Hey, what are you doing here, you traitor?
Yeah, the teacher's not here for you, wee little man.
There's only one way I'll be able to see this man.
Why are you all crowding the teacher? Give him a little space.
Peter, everything is okay. Zacchaeus, there's no need to be up that tree. Come on down.
Jesus, are you really sure you want to do that? I mean, you might want to keep him in that tree.
Zacchaeus, I'm coming to supper with you.
Do you realize who this man is, Jesus?
Teacher, I am not worthy to have you as my guest. I have cheated a lot of people.
So, what do you need to do?
I restore everything that I have taken. I give half of my goods to the poor, 4 times what I have taken.
Everyone, salvation has come to this man's house.
Come, teacher, I want to have you as my guest.
I want all of you to know this is the reason I came, to seek and to save those who were lost.
Christ came to the earth and gave us a living, breathing picture of a God who cares deeply about our needs. After Christ left the earth, the Spirit of God was at work in the church and in the lives of the followers of Christ. For our last story, we see God at work in the life of Saul of Tarsus. God saw something in Saul that most humans would not have seen, and God brought this persecutor into direct contact with one he was sent to persecute, a man named Ananias.
Lord, it's been 3 days since we received news that Saul was nearing our city. I pray for the safety of our believers, our wonderful community of believers, that you'll protect them from this zealous man and that you'll change his heart. Are you sure I'm the right person for the job? I know I was just praying for him and all, but this situation seems a lot like a mouse walking into a lion's den. But Lord, we've heard about the terrible things that this man has done to the believers in Jerusalem. And he's authorized by the leading priest to arrest anyone who calls upon your name. Okay, I'm on my way.
Hey, Ananias, what are you doing this time of day?
I'm heading over to Straight Street, to the house of Judas.
Why would you need to go all the way across the city? We need to be a little more cautious this time, and I don't think I need to remind you.
Well, I guess you could say I'm on a mission.
Like Mission Impossible?
It does, in fact, seem impossible. Not what I expected to do with my day, for sure.
You're being awfully secretive about this.
You might not approve.
Let me guess. You've been invited to have a sit-down dinner with Saul of Tarsus. Haha, funny joke, right?
How'd you know?
Are you insane? Are you crazy? That's like walking into a lion's den.
I have high orders. God has sent me to find him.
Why would God ask you to do something like this?
I just have to trust. Saul is praying right now. God has shown him a vision where I come in and lay hands on him so he can see again.
Do you want me to go as your backup? You know, stand right outside the door while you give a signal or something?
I haven't told God that we've heard about the terrible things that he's done to the believers in Jerusalem and that he's authorized by the leading priest to arrest everyone who calls upon his name.
Do you want me to bring my 5 strongest friends or?
No. The last thing God said was, go, for Saul is my chosen instrument to bring my message to the Gentiles and to kings and to the people of Israel. I will show him how much he must suffer for my namesake.
Tell you what, that truly sounds impossible. But God be with you, my friend. Our God is truly the God of the impossible.
God not only healed Saul, who became known as Paul, but he sent him throughout the known world as a missionary. His writings inspire and encourage us today. God sent Ananias to be the agent of healing. Ananias was willing to be used to bless others in the place of Christ. God calls us, like Ananias, to step out of comfort zones and be available to bless those around us who are searching for him. Our theme for this year is found in 1 Corinthians 15:57. Thanks be to God, he gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. We saw how he promised victory through the dream of an enemy soldier. Even if the odds seem to be against Gideon and Elisha, how the invisible armies of God are always more powerful. He gave peace in place of fear and anxiety. He gave confidence in the place of doubt and uncertainty. Christ, the Son of God, God with us, came to show us that the person that we are today does not have to be the person we are tomorrow. That forgiveness and repentance is possible. That victory is possible over sin through the life of Christ. Out of gratitude for all God has done for us, he is calling us to bless others in the way we live our lives. Thanks be to God. He gives us victory through our Lord Jesus Christ.
Thank you for waiting, ladies and gentlemen. We've invited the first class. Now we're inviting the executive class.
I was taking a trip on a plane the other day, just wishing that I could get out. When the man next to me saw the book in my hands and asked me what it was about, so I settled back in my seat, a bestseller, I said, a history and mystery in one. And then I opened up the book and began to read from Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. A virgin one holy night in the little town of Bethlehem. Angels gathered round him underneath the stars, singing praises to the great I Am. He walked on the water, healed the lame, and made the blind to see again. And for the first time here on earth, we learn that God could be a friend. And though we never ever did a single thing wrong, the angry chose him. And then he walked down the road and died on the cross, and that was the end of the beginning. The Bible, he said, and I've heard it all before. I've tried religion, it's shame and guilt, and I don't need it anymore. It's just a story of made-up tales, just to help the weak to survive. Well, let me read it again, I said, but listen closely, this is gonna change your life. He was born of a virgin one holy night in the little town of Bethlehem. Angels gathered round him underneath the stars, singing praises to the great I Am. He walked on the water, healed the lame, and made the blind to see again. And for the first time here on earth, we learned that God could be a friend. And though we never ever did a single thing wrong, the angry crowd chose him. And then he walked down the road and died on the cross, and that was the end of the beginning. The end of the beginning, he said with a smile. What more could there be? He is dead. You said they've hung him and put nails in his hands and a crown of thorns on his head. I said, I'll read it again, but this time there's more, and I believe this is true. His death wasn't the end, but the beginning of life that's completed in you. Don't you see? He did all this for you. And one holy night in the little town of Bethlehem. Angels gathered round him underneath the stars, singing praises to the great I Am. He walked on the water, healed the lame, and made the blind to see again. And for the first time here on earth, we learned that God can be a friend. And though he never ever did a single thing wrong, he was the one the crowd chose. And then he walked, and he died. But 3 days later, 3 days later, he rose.
Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for this beautiful day. Thank you for the beautiful Sabbath. Thank you for all the lessons teaching us about how you worked throughout history, from Elijah, through the kings, all the way to now, and how you overcame death, how you overcame sin so that we could have the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Help us to remember this lesson, to share it with those around us, and to claim the victory that you've given us. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. You are dismissed, and happy Sabbath.